the United States or other nations saying that they care about Hong Kong and expressing what they value about Hong Kong is not interference in Hong Kong's affairs. I think it actually helps reinforce the shared understanding of China, the people of Hong Kong, and the rest of the world that Hong Kong is a special place and can continue to be successful. And when mistakes are made or unwise policies take place, for the international community to comment on those is a natural thing. And the fundamental reason why Hong Kong has been so successful is that it's been able to utilize the one country, two systems framework under the basic law, exercising a high degree of autonomy to really be a special place for doing business. The strength of Hong Kong comes from the fact that it's different from the rest of China. It makes it unique, it makes it competitive, and it also makes it really attractive to the United States and other partners. The specific objectives of our consulate here, in addition to facilitating travel and helping American citizens as they live in Hong Kong, is to try and deepen the government-to-government relationship and also the private sector relationship between the United States and Hong Kong. We do everything we can to make it as easy as possible to travel to the United States, and really it's quite easy to get a U.S. visa, and we're very efficient at doing that. It may be possible in the future, it's not impossible, that Congress would pass legislation that would allow us to not have the visa process for bearers of Hong Kong passports. And if Congress were to pass that rule, then there would be no one more aggressive than myself and our consulate in trying to then implement that possibility as quickly as possible. It's the absence of a legislative rule allowing the visa waiver program to be applied to a jurisdiction, which is the main impediment to Hong Kong being part of the visa waiver program. And that would be specific to by passport. So if the visa waiver program were applied to Hong Kong, it would be for Hong Kong passports. So the concern that because there are residents from the mainland, or for that matter from other countries residing in Hong Kong, wouldn't actually be a factor in that.